DrumForge Mac Griner is a powerful and intuitive virtual drum instrument sampler plugin created by DrumForge in partnership with August Burns Red drummer Matt Griner. It was produced by Carson Slovak and Grant McFarland of Atrium Audio. Iconic drummer Matt Griner is best known for combining his creative grooves with devastating accuracy. Together, August Burns Red and Atrium Audio have produced 2 Grammy nominations. With DrumForge Mac Griner, you can use these same signature drum sounds in your own productions. This video breaks down the entire plugin and instrument in great detail and walks through every single element inside the sampler. This video is not intended to showcase the sound of the sampler. For sound demos, examples, and more information on the plugin, check out other DrumForge Mac Griner videos on our YouTube channel or visit drumforge.com. This plugin goes deep sonically and has a ton of features to cover, so let's get right into DrumForge Mac Griner. If there's something you'd like to learn about right away, check out the timestamps in the description below. Let's start from the top. DrumForge Mac Griner has 5 tabs that access different sections of the sampler. These tabs are the Kit Builder, Drum Editor, Song Builder, Internal Mixer, and MIDI Mapping. Click the Mac Griner logo to adjust the plugin settings. Below that is the preset menu, where you can save and load Matt's presets as well as your own. Now let's explore each module. The first tab is the Kit Builder. Here you can swap between the different shell and cymbal samples. You can also build a kit from scratch. Each square in this window is what we refer to as a drum card. Each drum card acts as a slot for shells or cymbals in your drum kit. Click on each card to hear the sound, and double-click to go into the engineering setup for that specific drum. You can mute, solo, or erase each card. Just be careful, when you erase the card, you erase any automation and mix settings that are associated with that card. This tab lets you control the balance between several mics on every single drum and cymbal. You can also pan each of these sources however you would like. Each mic also contains attack, sustain, and release controls. These can be adjusted from the ASR tab at the bottom of the plugin. This is really useful for getting the perfect ratio of punch to length on each mic. By default, the attack is set to 0 milliseconds, which is the fastest setting. The sustain and release are set to 10 seconds, which is the full length of any sample. The velocity section gives you more control over how DrumForge Mac Griner interprets MIDI. The curve knob controls how hard or soft the average range of velocities is triggered. Turning this to the left makes a wider range of velocities trigger harder samples. Turning it to the right makes the average range of velocities trigger softer samples. This has a huge effect on that 60 to 100 velocity range. The minimum and maximum knobs set the limit for MIDI velocity. If a performance doesn't require much dynamic range, the minimum knob can be increased to make the lowest velocities trigger harder samples. If you never want to use the hardest velocities, just dial back the max knob. The dynamics knob adjusts the volume of the playback. Turning this knob down reduces dynamic range between the softest and loudest samples. This is really useful if you like writing with soft articulations like ghost notes, but they're getting lost in the mix. The sample tab lets you get really detailed with sample selection. This menu on the left lets you choose which articulations to adjust. The middle column allows you to boost or cut the volume of each velocity layer. Click on a velocity layer to select it, and once selected, the samples associated with that layer will be editable on the right column. Click on each sample name to audition it. This column is useful if you want to limit the amount of samples for each layer. For example, you could select the hardest velocity layer and turn off every sample except for one, and that would mean that every time the hardest hit happens, it's the exact same sample. Or maybe you just want to remove a sample that you don't like the sound of. The Config tab gives you options for the pitch and humanization of the drum. The first section on the Config tab deals with pitch and provides both coarse and fine-tuning knobs. The coarse pitch knob adjusts the pitch of the drum up or down in semitone increments, and the fine pitch knob up or down in cent increments. If a snare needs more weight, try tuning it down. If it needs more pop, try tuning it up. This actually multiplies the amount of shell and cymbal choices that you can access. Next to the pitch section is the alternation section. This feature automatically alternates hands and feet based on input speed for successive drum hits programmed with a single MIDI note. The feature can be enabled with a switch at the top, and the threshold can be set to determine the time in milliseconds between hits that is necessary to trigger the automatic alternation. This is great for getting realistic drums without having to program all the MIDI that looks like this. Pro tip, this button can be automated. If you keep an automation lane for the alternation button, you can actually save a ton of time by turning it on when writing MIDI that requires it. All these editor options give unparalleled control over the tone of each source. Now let's move on to the Song Builder. This tab contains tons of Matt's own MIDI performances for use in your music. If you have any previous DrumForge samplers, their MIDI grooves will be located in the Packs section here. Each groove is categorized by which cymbal the leading hand is on and which section of the song it's suggested for. This is awesome if you need something like a hi-hat dominant drum part for a breakdown. Set both categories to any to see the full list of grooves. To audition a groove, simply double-click on it. To use it, drag the groove to the queue. Once in the queue, additional grooves can be dragged to create an entire section. These can be reordered within the queue. One awesome feature in this section is what happens when you add a fill. If you add a 2-bar fill after a 4-bar verse, the verse is automatically shortened to accommodate the fill. This can be deactivated by clicking the link button. This is really useful because you can drag 4 of the same 4-bar verse grooves and add a 2-bar fill for a 16-bar MIDI file without any editing. Once the cue is how you want it, turn it into a MIDI object by clicking and dragging the Drag to Session button. This will allow you to drag the grooves you created onto any MIDI track in your DAW. DrumForge Matt Griner includes an incredibly powerful internal mixer. This allows a full drum mix to be completed within the plugin. Each channel can be expanded to adjust the mic faders from the drum editor. You can also add your own one-shot samples by clicking the green plus button next to each drum. Each sample you add has a MIDI tab where the attack and sustain can be adjusted. You can also fine-tune the pitch to blend it with DrumForge Matt Griner's sounds. This feature can only access samples from one folder at a time. Make sure any samples you want to add to DrumForge Matt Griner are all in the same folder. If you already keep all of your samples in the same place, then just set the path right here. The interface defaults to the overview mode, which gives you a bird's eye view of each channel's processing. The various processors can be turned on and off by clicking on them and drag them to rearrange the order. To change the view for a single channel, click the drop-down menu at the top. Entire mixer chains can be also saved or loaded from this menu. If you want to change the view for all channels, select a processor tab from the bottom. DrumForge Matt Griner features three different saturation types, tube, tape, and distortion. Increase the gain to apply the saturation, and lower the output to match the level. The compressor module is a great way to shape the dynamics of each channel. It has all the standard features you'd expect, like threshold, release, and ratio. The attack is toggled between a punchy slow attack and a controlled fast attack. It also features a selectable high-pass filter for the detection circuit so that the low end doesn't trigger the compression. The 8 mix groups feature a special custom compressor that can only be found within DrumForge Matt Griner. This bus compressor is designed specifically for punchy drums with controlled transients. The EQ module is a 4-band analog style EQ with adjustable Q widths. The top and bottom bands can be turned into a filter, bell, or shelf shape. The clipper module is based on our own clipping algorithm. With one knob, you can trim the transient peaks and add harmonic excitement to any source. Use the reverb module to put any channel in a specific room. Select one of the 9 rooms and use the wet knob to control the mix. If it's competing with the natural drum sound, dial in some pre-delay to make the reverb hit slightly after the transient. The send module is an awesome way to get more control over the processing. Send any channel to any 4 of the 8 included group channels. This is a send, so the signal will be parallel to the main output of the channel. These can be sent either pre or post fader. Click the number next to the send knob to activate each send. Now's a good time to cover the routing inside the mixer. The master output for each track is controlled by the black box above the fader. Click this to tell that channel to route through any of the 8 mix groups or send it outside of the plugin with any of the 16 outputs. A common way to set this up is to use a few buses as groups for shells and one for cymbals and then route these groups to a master bus. Try combining track routing and sends to experiment with parallel processing. If you want to stem out from DrumForge Matt Griner into your DAW, just send each channel to its own output, then create an audio or aux track with that output set as the input. In Pro Tools, that's going to look like this. And in Reaper, that's going to look like this. Check the manual of your specific DAW to find out how to do this for yourself if you're using something different. The last tab is the MIDI mapping section. Here, any note can be configured to trigger any drum or cymbal. There are separate MIDI CCs for the left and right hand articulations of every shell, so you can get exactly the performance that you want. If you want to have the program automatically alternate the hits, go back to the drum editor section of this video. To reassign a hit, just drag the drum to the MIDI note that you want. Clicking the MIDI icon to the right of any currently assigned articulation will enable MIDI note learn. While this mode is active, the articulation will be assigned to the next MIDI note that is played. If two samples are triggered from the same note, both will play every time. DrumForge Mac Griner includes several standard MIDI mappings. If you are used to writing MIDI in a certain way, or you've already written MIDI for a different plugin, or someone sends you MIDI that they wrote in a different plugin, you're already covered. If you make a custom map, you can also save and load it here. Selecting any drum icon from the piano roll will display MIDI CC information below. This information includes the CC channel assigned to the drum or cymbal, an invert option for the CC range that's selected, and a range slider allowing you to select the minimum and maximum CC values for triggering the drum. Last but not least, there are some important plugin settings that we need to go over. Clicking on the Mac Griner logo will launch the plugin settings window, where you can tweak some of the aspects of how the plugin operates. For most, these settings will only need to be adjusted once to get the plugin running optimally for your machine. The first option is your library path. If you've installed your samples elsewhere from the default location, use the Browse option to reference that folder instead. This will also need to be done if your samples are ever moved after the plugin has been installed. As a note of caution, DrumForge Mac Griner samples should not be saved in the same folder location as your DrumShots samples. Below your library path, there is an option to enable OpenGL. When enabled, the graphics performance inside the plugin will be improved. Please note, this feature requires a graphics card that supports OpenGL. Here, you can also determine how the plugin reacts to the scroll wheel on your mouse. Using the two checkboxes, you can enable or disable fader and knob movements based on mouse wheel input. Next, we have the playback voices. This is how many drum sample streams can play simultaneously. If you're running DrumForge Mac Griner on an older machine or in a session with many different resource-intensive plugins, you may wish to limit the number of voices used during playback. By default, the maximum number of voices is 200. In order to preserve system resources, you can print your drums to audio tracks prior to mixing the session. This will allow you to use the maximum number of voices while programming without losing any fidelity once your drums are finished. DrumForge Mac Griner is an incredibly detailed drum sampler with tons of samples, editing, and mixing options. For those just getting started with drum sampling, we recommend starting with some presets to get familiar with how the plugin works before moving into more advanced options. Grooves are a great way to get a quick and dirty drum track set up for testing out various features too. We are super excited to share this tool with you and hear what you create with it. Make sure to tag us on social media whenever it ends up in one of your productions. To learn more about DrumForge Mac Griner, check out the other videos on our YouTube channel or visit the best online resource for professional drum sounds, drumforge.com.